the last video, we have just gone through the reflection of the light. I have taught you the concept of reflection of the light. In today's video, we are going to do the actual practical of the reflection of the light. In the last video, I have explained the laws of reflection of the light, that is, angle of incident is always equal to the angle of reflection. For this, we will prove how the angle of incident is equal to the angle of reflection. Let's do the activity. The things needed for the activity is pencil, you need a protractor, mirror, see this is a plain mirror, pin, blank paper and scale. Okay? So how you have to do? First you have to fill the paper on this mount board. This is a board support, then you have to fit it properly. Then you have to draw a line. You have to draw a line with the help of the scale. Okay? Why I have drawn the line? To fit the mirror. You have to fit the mirror like this. Okay? Then you have to adjust one of the points. Suppose I have taken this point. With the help of the protractor, now see this is 90 degree. Now you have to count from like this. This is 10, 20, 30. So this will be the 30 degree. Okay. Now I will draw a line. This is 90. This is 10, 20, 30. So I will draw a line. This is a normal, or we can say this is a normal line. This is angle of incidence. Okay, now in the law of reflection, what we have learned, that angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. So you have to, this is a plane mirror. Now I'll fit this plane mirror on the line properly. Adjust the plane mirror properly. You have to fit the plane mirror. Properly. Now this is angle of incidence. This is the angle of incidence. Now to the angle of incidence, you have to put two pins. See, one and this is two. See this, I have adjusted. Now see, this is the angle of incidence. Now these are the angle of incidence. Now you have to adjust the pin in a such a way that, now see, in a mirror you can see this image. You can see this image, yes or no? You have to adjust in a such a way that they will coincide. You have to adjust in such a way that, now you can see this image of this line. You have to adjust in such a way that they will come in together. They are in a single line. Can you see they all four pins are in the same line? Can you see this? See properly. Can you see these? The four pins are in the same line. See, if we have to close the eyes and you have to see these four pins will be, see this will be the image, and if you will see it properly, you will get that all the four pins are in the one line. Are you getting this? See properly, if you will see that two pins and these two pins, you will get they are in the single line. Yes, see properly, you can see. They are in the one line. Can you get that? Yes, you can see it properly now. See, the
four pins are in the same line. So now we have got the 2 points. Now if you will see it properly, this was the first point. This we have done before that. So this is a P and this I can write Q. This point I can write Q. And here I can write P1 and this can I write Q1. Okay? Now see, I will remove this and we will check whether this two P1 and Q1, I will draw one line through this. See, now this will be the reflected ray. Now we have to measure whether the angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. See, this was 90 degree. See, this line is 30, 10, 20, 30. And if you will see, 10, 20, 30. Yes, see. And you get this? So this is 60. Here is also 60. Here is also 60. Am I right? If you will see properly. Means it is nothing but 30. 10, 20, 30 and 10, 20, 30. So this is also 30 degree. Means it means angle of incident is always equal to the angle of reflection. I hope you have understood the activity of angle of reflection. That is law of reflection of the light.